Hola, me llamo Laura, soy de Estados Unidos, pero ahora estoy en España y esto es un Spanish tidbit.
The words introducir and presentar can be a little confusing in Spanish, probably because their meanings are surprisingly similar. But the main and specific cause of confusion is both introducir and presentar can be, and often are, used for the English verb to introduce. In fact, while preparing for this video, I noticed both introducir and presentar are used almost exactly like introduce and presentar in English, except for one very specific situation. So let's start with that one situation. In English, when we make someone known to another person, we say we introduce them. Well, in Spanish, when you make someone known to another person, you can't use introducir, you have to use presentar. He introduced me to his friends would be me presento a sus amigos. You'll hear stuff like te presento a mi hermano all the time, which is the best way to say I introduce you to my brother. And I guess really in English, we just say this is my brother, which right now, for the first time ever, seems kind of weird to me. So that's the rule. In English, we introduce people, but in Spanish, they present people. It's a little awkward at first, but nothing too crazy. We actually do the same thing in English, just in formal situations only. Allow me to present my daughter. So basically, our formal way is their normal way. Now, when you introduce something to somebody, as opposed to someone, you still use introducir like we do in English. It's just when you're introducing a person that you have to use presentar. Let's look at some newspaper headlines. Blanquita Nieves presentó oficialmente a su novio en la Divina Comedia. Blanquita Nieves introduced officially her boyfriend in the Divine Comedy. Since Blanquita introduced her boyfriend and her boyfriend is a person, they used presentar. But then look at this one. Black Panther. Mira el espectacular trailer que nos introduce al mundo de Wakanda. That means Black Panther, watch the spectacular trailer that introduces us to the world of Wakanda. They can use introducir now because the trailer introduces us to the world of Wakanda. So even if Wakanda is a person, I have no clue, the world of Wakanda is still a thing. Thus, introducir for introduce is the way to go. Got it? Pretty simple, no? Another interesting use of introducir in Spanish is to put one thing inside of another. El médico introdujo las pinzas en la herida. The doctor introduced the tweezers into the wound. We use introduce like this in English too, just very rarely. Mainly for liquids? They introduced 40 milliliters of, I don't know, give me a break, I'm teaching Spanish here. I think I would say inserted the tweezers, or just put the tweezers. So introducir can be translated into a lot of different things, like to insert, put, even pour or dump. But notice all those words are different ways of saying put one thing inside of another. Other than that, the use of introducir and presentar is pretty straightforward. They work exactly like introduce and present do in English. Introducen nueva variedad de papas. That means they introduce a new variety of potato. That could be saying a couple different things, but since I read the article, I know they're talking about a new kind of potato that came from South Korea. And when you bring a plant, animal, or disease to a place for the first time, you introduce it. In Spanish too, introducir. Side note, potato is papa in Latin America, but patata in Spain. Probably a bunch of other stuff too. Spanish speakers, do you have any other words for potato where you live? Leave me a comment below or send me a message. Another example, introducen sistema de pagos móviles Alipay en Dinamarca. They introduce the mobile payment system Alipay in Denmark. When you bring something into use for the first time, you introduce it in English and Spanish. Introducir. Now a couple quick presentar examples. Western Union presentó su nueva plataforma para giros y operaciones empresariales. Western Union presented their new platform for transfers and business operations. Last one, AN, the initials of la Asamblea Nacional, presentó acuerdo para restituir la democracia en Venezuela. AN presented an accord to return democracy in Venezuela. And that's it. When you introduce a person, go with presentar, not introducir, but for everything else, introducir and presentar basically work exactly like they do in English. Yes, basically exactly. If you like this video, there are lots more just like it at SpanishDude.com/tidbits. And if that's still not enough, my premium course, Fun with Words, has even more. Those might be better, actually. I'm trying to keep these tidbits short, but in the premium videos, we're not limited for time, so I can let the old brain run a little freer. Learn all about Fun with Words at SpanishDude.com/fun. For my grammar freaks, every Spanish quickie is listed for you at SpanishDude.com/quickies. And if you haven't already subscribe to the Spanish Dude newsletter, you can correct that at SpanishDude.com/free-updates. I'll notify you when I post a new video, plus you'll get bonus videos and discounts not available to the public. A special shout out to mi amiga Laura en España. I hope you're still kicking butt with the Spanish, though you sound great already. Thanks so much for the intro, Laura. If you'd like to appear in a future Spanish tidbit, go to SpanishDude.com/tidbits and follow the instructions. Okay, nos vemos, amigo. Until the next tidbit, I'm Jordan, and I love Spanish. Woo!